will now be a medium-sized intermission.
That's bad for a starter, but now perhaps something a little more savory.
Ooh, I don't like this. Ooh, I don't like that. Ooh, I don't think much to all this. Ooh, fancy using that wallpaper. Fancy using mustard. Ooh, is that a proper one? Ooh, it's not real. I don't think it's a proper restaurant unless they give you finger bowls. Ooh, I don't like him. I'm going to have a baby in a few years.
Please excuse my wife. She may appear to be rather nasty, but underneath she has a heart of formica. Sorry about that.
That's all right, sir. We get all sorts of lines in here. The head waiter will be along to abuse you in a few moments. And now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go and commit suicide.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right. It's not because of anything serious.
Quite frankly, I'm against people who commit suicide. I don't like that sort of person at all. I'm plain people and I'm proud of it. My mother's the salt of the earth and I don't take the pill because it's nasty.
Please excuse my wife. She may not be very beautiful and she may have no money and she may be a little talentless, boring and dull. But on the other hand... Sorry, I can't think of anything.
Fine. I'm the head waiter. This is a vegetarian restaurant only. We serve no animal flesh of any kind. We're not only proud of that, we're smug about it. So if you were to come in here asking me to rip open a small defenseless chicken so you could chew its skin and eat its intestines, then I'm afraid I would have to ask you to leave.
No.
Likewise, if you were to ask me to slice the sides off a cow and serve it with a small piece of its liver, or indeed drain the life's blood from a pig before cutting off one of its legs, or carve the living giblets from a sheep and serve them with the fresh brains, bowels, guts and spleen of a small rabbit, we wouldn't do it! Not for food, anyway.
Why, frankly, I'm against people who give vent to their loquacity by extraneous bombastic circumlocution. Oh, I don't like that.
Sometimes, Shirley, I think you're almost human.
Do you know I still wet my bed?
Once I married someone who was beautiful and young and gay and free. Whatever happened to her?
You divorced her and married me.
I met my second wife at a second wife swapping party. Trust me to arrive late.
Always were late, weren't you, Thompson?
Hello, headmaster. What are you doing here?
Fine, thank you. No more sherry for me, don't you know? Walner House beat Badger House with a second cuppa. Remarkable. We had to put most of the second form to sleep. No, padre. Bad business. They were beginning to play with themselves. Still, you haven't seen my wife anywhere, have you?
No.
Oh, thank God for that.
Ooh, don't like him. Do you know what I mean? All men are the same.
Imagine not that these four walls contain the mighty owl of Thebes. Four gentles all. Beauty sits most closely to them it can construe.
No, it doesn't.
Sorry. Fine. Would you care for a glass of blood? Or what a giveaway?
We'd like to see the menu, please. I don't think it's a proper restaurant unless you have a proper menu. And anyway, I might be pregnant.
Perhaps you would care for a drink.
Ever since you've married me, Douglas, you've treated me like an albatross.
Evening.
Good evening.
I hope you're going to enjoy me this evening. I'm the special. Try me with some rice.
I beg your pardon?
A Hopkins au gratin à la chef.
Oh, how do you do?
Don't play with the food.
Just not here. I don't think it's a proper meal without pudding. My husband's an architect.
One word of warning, sir. A little tip. Don't have any of the vicar over there. He's been here 2 weeks and nobody's touched him. Enough said?
Yes, thank you.
Well, I must get along or I'll spoil. Janet, to the kitchen.
Dead bishop in the lobby, sir. I don't know who keeps bringing them in here.
Oh, I don't like that. I think it's silly. It's not a proper sketch. You had a proper punchline. I mean, I don't know much about anything. I'm stupid. I'm Muggins. Nobody cares what I think. I'm always the one that has to do everything. Nobody cares about me. Well, I've got to have a lot of bloody babies, and they can bloody well care about me. It makes you sick off this television. They never stop talking. He'll be the ruination of her rhythm method.
There will now be a whopping great intermission, during which small ice creams in very large boxes will be sold. Another way we can drive people away from the cinema is by showing you advertisements.
Do you like this? Or how about this? Or perhaps you prefer this latest model? Then why not come to us? We supply only the very best models. After the show, why not visit the La Gondola restaurant? Just 2 minutes from this performance. The manager, Mr. Luigi Vercotti, will be pleased to welcome you and introduce you to a wide variety of famous Sicilian delicacies. Here you can relax in comfort in friendly surroundings, or if you wish, you may drink and dance till midnight. At the La Gondola restaurant, you can sample all the spicy pleasures of the Mediterranean. The head waiter will be pleased to show you his specialities. Or why not ask the cook for something really hot? Yes, for an evening you'll never forget, it's the La Gondola restaurant, Chelsea. Parkhurst, Dartmoor, and the Scrubs.